There is no secret on how much the Ugly Dolls are a huge success. It's all of them having toys and other things. Next to like Hasbro's My Little Pony and other product placements. And so what get their own movie is this one. So, to cut to the chase, the Ugly Dolls were most likely popular for little children and all sorts of that stuff. They've been around for a very long time. And not to mention, lots of product placements about them being around. This movie is already a few years older. Not gonna lie, like, when they release this movie, it's supposed to be for, like, little grandchildren. And, keep them quiet for, like, a while. The Ugly Dolls movie is about, basically toys that want to be played with humans. It's amongst the world. Okay, so it came out in 2019. But the point is, the movie, it was almost grimly forgotten, and people say this is not really a great film, despite its full anime and budget of different Ugly Dolls with different personalities, even have different names. Yeah, the Ugly Dolls have, like, different shape and sizes of characters. I'm gonna do this one quickly as possible. Plus, I'm kind of running out of different games since my Xbox One took a dump. And I do have this game on Xbox One. So it's, like, money down the drain. Plus, this movie is a musical number. The animation doesn't look that bad until we get to these scenes. Where it acts like a comic book style. That's pretty much where all that animation budget went. The main character you see in the middle, all that pink is Poxy, who is the main character of the story, among the other characters. Especially Lucky Bat, the cat. Lucky Bat, which I just said, Ox. And other characters that are popular in this movie have the original great voice actors of Carrie Quartzen, Hank Jonas, Julian Nard, Luke Sheldon, and Pitbull. The only thing they left off is Wanda Sykes playing and one of the Ugly Dolls. This movie's basic plot is them trying to find something new in their outside world of Uglyville. How that they finally get the chance to see what's in the outside world. Go for the pie bin, eat other people, toys of personalities of regular humanoid toys. Speaking of that word, it does a semblance to Toy Story. You turn to the end of the movie. They meet like the other normie toys until they encounter obviously the main bad guy of the story, Lou. He's obviously the villain that wants to get rid of the Ugly Dolls for them being hideous. And sees on whoever's not normal colors can dispose of them, and harsh, and he wants to make sure all the Ugly Dolls are welcome in their place by challenging them come to the beloved children. And you will accept them. About the actually leave them and never return ever again. So yeah, I'm not to give too much away of this movie. This one had like box office millions of dollars. Or so the simple story of them that wants them to get cared for children around the world. But who accepts them on how hideous they are? Hideously, got stuff in my throat. Doesn't want them to be accepted by children on how, but their appearance do not accept them. The animation is not half bad, but people pretty much forget this movie existed. It does have some musical numbers in it. And the film is only like an hour and 28 minutes. And you know, well, there is like a little bit of a backstory between Lou and Mayor Ox, the one with the big bunny ears. That's green. And they were built in a factory a long time ago. And they go to their separate ways. Them live in Uglyville, the rest of them live into their little actual normal city place. And they want to make sure all the toys, like them, don't have to mess around and get dirty. Or they'll end up in a big, huge washing machine. And they want to make sure to get played by the children. There's not much else to say about this movie. That this film is just them having musical numbers, just to add the movie's timing. Not to mention weird random backgrounds that change up colors here and there. Voice acting is not half bad. But this movie's timing is just them and singing throughout the entire film. And I don't want to get copyrighted by playing any songs. They want to make sure or they accept them the way they are as being ugly. Or they'll end up in the shredder machine. And one of the ugly dolls had to carry random stuff. And just had like a sad moment for like nearly a minute, and then comes back to being all cheerful with someone. I'm from the city. And they live in is cheerful and depressing. Yeah, I totally forgot her name, Mandy. I want them to make sure they get their dreams come true. Except the way they are. Doesn't matter what their appearance are, is the way they are supposed to be is created. The way things are. Accept it who you are. That's basically the movie's plot convenience. It's idea of a good time. It's a pretty friendly film that you want to watch for like nearly an hour and 20 minutes. he'll find this movie interesting or less thrilling. It just takes its time to get to the point of having the other characters finally enter in the city they are in. What I'm trying to explain is Ugly Dolls could have been a little bit better from its own story plot. On convenience and development. If they wanted to be playing with the humans in the first place, they could have done that in the very beginning. But they just do all this train stuff to add the movie's timing and then set them the way they are created to be. In a certain, what's the word for it? Ugly toys as they are. And they just keep on playing like references to other songs that we already know about. So I would say Ugly Dolls can be accepted to be either good or bad. And you'll find this movie a little bit cheerful for children. I know this movie's been reviewed by many people on YouTube before. Countless times when that first came out in 2019. But I'm pretty sure people will easily forget this movie existed. It's like it's product placement of the toys of them. It's been around since the early 2000s. Trust me, I did talk about most likely these type of kids films before. I kind of wish that Ugly Dolls movie would have a little bit of more action pack in it and a little bit more intense moments. But I'll give this movie credit. It does have a pretty nice ending. And when she enters in the 20-word human world, even though this movie tries to be a bit funny at times, but I am a laugh than a few times at all, except for the scene here. That did actually make me laugh once. Okay, that's actually pretty funny. And the movie ends with them being played by other kids. Or the villain gets what he deserves. So, you might like the Ugly Dolls movie or not, this film is going to be pretty much almost less successful than other films that you've seen before. For the time being. Ugly Dolls, the movie, is kind of, well, in the word for it, almost mediocre at best. Just had to add the timing of them singing throughout the whole entire movie for like a whole hour and 20 minutes. Just whole budget. You'll either like this movie or not. How the Ugly Dolls it's meant for little young children and around the world just to buy their product placement toys. For me, I'd rather be just watch this movie rather or a few times and that's it. It's not as the best film out there or not nearly as a perfectly a great film or as good as Toy Story. Toy Story had some great action and tensile moments. Ugly Dolls just has them want to be played by children and that's basically it. It's just kind of like almost a rip-off out of the Toy Story series. I really don't got much else to say about Ugly Dolls. I mean, it's just there, just to exist. And on that movie's budget, the scenery of doing only two locations, Uglyville and most likely, well, Make It Free. The factory they were built from, and most likely Normalville, a place for they set them to be the hideous or not. It's basically, it doesn't matter what their appearance are, it's just the way they are created by them. So Ugly Dolls, the movie, is would have been a better comedy movie than they did some slapsticks here and there. But sometimes it'll be almost halfway a doll mess at times. Or everything's all made out of cloth and rugs and buttons. That's why they're called Ugly Dolls for a reason. So in other words, this film could have been a so much better or action-packed adventure. Well, I guess that's how it is when you make certain movies for a $1 billion budget. You want have an utter mess of forgetful, forgotten wasteland of other films that were not impressive, but other films I watched it, and as a kid. If this movie was made in the early 2000s, it would have been so much better. Or that way, people can enjoy the films that were created years ago. This film, however, would almost be less forgetful. Oh, they done so much of it. Sure, the voice acting to these characters aren't terrible, but at least they tried to make this movie impressively. And the word for it. Passable. Now it says right here, it costs like $45 billion. It does say a disaster, terrible. Well, you might have to look up these guys as a review. And right here. Just look up my great old Baz reviews and let's see. Who's review? Empty Matt's review. So, I'm just gonna say it. This movie was not super great at all. Sure, you could put it on for the grandchildren of theirs. It'll get them crying for most of the times. All natural moments. So, I give Ugly Dolls the movie 5.6 out of 10. It would have been a little bit more interesting to see them have grand adventures entering the human world. But it's kind of unforgiving that we don't get that kind of idea project in this universe we live in. So I had to force myself to review this some again. See you guys next time.